Next, I will choose the tiny bubble and click to animation. So from here, I click path animation and I will draw a curve of the bubble rising up in the liquid. So I click and then the second click, and when I move, it creates a curve. Third click, fourth, fifth, and the last click. And when I'm done, I click enter. So it will automatically preview the animation. So next, I click in medium bubble. Same thing, draw the curve. Start from the center of the circle. First click, I want to move it opposite direction. Click here, the last one, and then click enter. When you hit enter, it will be the last point. Go to selection panel, choose the big bubble, and draw the curve again. From the center of the curve, the big bubble, I want it to move more slowly, so just three curves. Hit enter. So you can always open the animation pane up here. So tiny bubble, here you can choose the timing. On click or with previous after previous. So the first one will be on click. The medium bubble will be with the first bubble. So I want it to move at the same time. And the big bubble will be with the same time. And if you want it to slow, you can choose delay. Go to timing, change delay. I'll have this in the medium bubble will be delayed half a second after the first tiny bubble goes up, and 1 second for the big bubble. And I can choose it repeat until the end of the slide, so the bubble would just keep rising up after it reached the top. So let's play it again. See the small, the medium, and the big follow each other because they are half a second delay. It's a bit fast, so I will make it slower, 3 seconds. Click here, change to 3 seconds, and play it. So that's much better. That's what I want. You can see that it repeat again and again until the end of the animation of the slides. So the big bubble is a bit off, so I will move it a bit to center, and then I move this path to the center also. So you can see that all of the bubbles start from the middle at the bottom and rising up. That's what I want.